Hey, this is the C&D channel. I'm Chris, this is Dave, and this is MMA for You. We're going to be doing our predictions for UFC 174, Johnson versus Baga Itunov, which happens on June 14th on pay-per-view with prelims on FX, actually. What do you think of the card overall, my man?
The card was always pretty okay, pretty solid. I mean, again, it's Demetri Johnson, I mean, it's a guy I really like, so I'm looking forward to for this call.
Nice, man. Nice, yeah.
So let's talk about the top of the first fight. Who do you got?
You know what, man? We got Demetrius Johnson versus a guy that's a part of this Dagestani invasion in the UFC right now, and Ali Baga Itunov. But you know what? I gotta stick with the champ, man.
Exactly, Demetri Johnson. I mean, again, 19-2-1 records, 4 KO, TKO, 7 submission. Still young, 27 years old, 5 fight win streak. Train at AMC
Pancration. Yeah, other guys that train out of that. That's a Matt Humes gym.
Oh, wow.
Trains out, yeah. Trains with, I think Matt Brown trains there, Rich Franklin trained there, and Josh Barnett, I think, trained there as well.
Absolutely. He is the UFC flyweight champion. Why is he a UFC flyweight champion? Because he's quick. He's good, strong, a very strong stand out.
Very technical, too. That's
yeah, technical.
Like. Really technical, yeah.
I mean, you know, again, technical is one thing. He is really good with a combination. When you are technical and you know how to use a combination, you are very scary. And also, he has a very strong wrestling.
Oh, man. I remember his fight against John Moraga. I mean, this guy's, he got like 12 for 12 takedowns, or some like crazy stat. He hit every takedown, and they looked like football tackles, man.
See?
I mean, they were just really nice.
I mean, no doubt this guy is a tank, but not just that. The crazy thing of all this is, I mean, you got a guy who can do, who have a good stand out, you know, who is quick, and who is big, who is strong, and usually are weak on the cardio. No, this guy is strong cardio. He can last 5 rounds, no problem.
Oh, man, he's on 5 rounds, yeah. No problem.
And he has a good takedown defense as well.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy's solid all the way. I mean, you couldn't find any guy who is so well-rounded and then fast.
Yeah,
exactly. I mean, this is solid.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, to add to that, too, I like that he makes mid-fight adjustments in his fight. If you watch his fight against John Dodson, he got knocked down or wobbled in the first two rounds, adjusted in the third, started using the tie clinch, showing off those knees, his counter wrestling, you know, his ability to get back to his feet is really good. He's
great scramble.
Great scrambling.
Yes.
Showed some good top control, some good Brazilian jiu-jitsu against John Moraga, getting a fifth round armbar, actually.
I mean, you mentioned a really good point. A lot of good fighter. They don't know how to adjust when they're on the fight. I mean, first round, second round, for example, BJJ, when he loses two rounds, he's done.
Yeah.
It, you know,
BJ
Penn,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
He just continue, just like defeated, done.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of fighters have a brain fart situation.
Yeah.
They lose two rounds, they KO. He, Demetri Johnson, different.
Right.
He know how to adjust, fight back. That's a true champion right there.
Exactly. He's fighting a tough guy in Ali Baga Itunov, though, man. 13-2 record, 5 wins by KO or TKO, 4 wins by sub. He's 28 years old on an 11-fight win streak.
Wow, look at that. That's a tough, that's an awesome, you know, record. It shows that this guy is not easy. He's difficult. He trained at Jackson.
Yeah, Jackson's and Fight Night's team with, like, Vitaly Minnikov as well.
And heavy-handed, good boxing. You know, Sambo background. I mean, anybody.
You know the Sambo guys. Yeah.
Anybody who is Sambo guy is scary. He can suplex you to death.
Exactly. He's good in the clinch, and just has good overall takedowns with his Sambo background. His nickname is Puncher. I mean, the guy has some seriously heavy hands. He has a really good right hand. That's kind of scary for Demetrius Johnson. I think Demetrius Johnson, though, can out-quick the guy. I think he's going to be the quicker fighter. I think he's going to be more experienced in five-round fights.
Absolutely.
That's why I gotta go with Demetrius Johnson to win this one.
Yeah, I mean, as strong as the opponent is, I think Demetrius Johnson will win this fight because what you talk about, the quickness, and he's very experienced. And the bottom line, he can last the fight round with running around, you know, dodging the opponent, attack, wrestling, defense. This guy got it all.
You got it, man.
Okay. All right, let's talk about next fight.
Co-main event, we got Rory McDonald versus Tyron Woodley. This fight most likely has a welterweight title, you know, aspiration, you know, nice. Like, you know, contendership stuff with that.
I mean, Rory McDonald, he's been there, done that, he's ready for this challenge. I mean, he's still young, but, you know, still. I mean, 16-2 records, 6 KO, TKO, 6 submission. I mean, you know, he has done so impressive for me. I mean, to me, he has a good kickboxing, good jab, strong kick, you know, good sprawl, good wrestling, you know, a strong ground and pound. I mean, this guy, this amazing.
Yeah, well, you know, he trains out of TriStar with the likes of George St. Pierre, something Garcia, I forgot, Jesus, not Steve Garcia, the Dominican Nightmare, a lot of good guys out of TriStar. He's also big for 170.
Yes, you know? He is.
And he showed in the Damian Maia fight a really good sprawl, along with he's already had some solid kickboxing, good ground and pound.
He has a good BJJ too. I would just want to interrupt because, you know, have a good wrestling, have a good BJJ, that's a deadly combination. And it has a good kickboxing and good jab. I mean, you got all everything that you needed.
Yeah, but he's fighting Tyron Woodley, man. 13-2 record, 4 wins by KO or TKO, 5 wins by sub. He's 32 years old on a 2-fight win streak. Most recently beating Carlos Condit.
Oh, wow.
McDonald most recently beating Damian Maia. He trains out at ATT Evolution and just ATT in general. He's got some strong wrestling, you know. NCAA, you know, all that, like, good stuff. Some strong takedown defense. He's just a strong guy, too. If you look at him, he's really thick. He has really strong. You can see his really thick legs. Very athletic and explosive. I hate to use that term, but it's true with him. He's getting into clinch. His boxing's really improving. He showed heavy-handedness as of late, you know. Knocked out Jay Haran, knocked out Kochjak, dropped Marquardt. Yeah. And he's actually pretty good at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He hasn't shown it as of late. When he first started his MMA, he was showing good Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. One of the problems with him, though, is his cardio has shown not to be the greatest. Who do you have, man?
I mean, you know, to be honest with you, this is a very tough fight. You know, I mean, you got one guy who has heavy hand there who is just, you know, recognized as a tyrant, gonna come here and dominate again. But again, you know, you have to understand, constantly attacking, have a heavy hand there, it costs a lot of cardio.
Yeah, he's
a big guy.
He's a strong guy. He's not necessarily
He's a strong guy. But yeah. I mean, Rory McDonald there, he's a big guy too. But this guy got everything that you need. He got good defense, he got good offense, he's just well rounded.
Well, he started MMA when he was like 13 or some like ridiculously young age, like MMA, you know, not just kickboxing, not
exactly.
Just
exactly. And look, like how old he is right now.
Yeah,
he's still young, and he got energy, and I don't doubt about his cardio compared to his opponent. So I said Rory McDonald.
You know what, man? This is like a tough fight for me to call. I'm actually gonna go with Woodley here.
Wow! So yeah, you're still thinking the heavy hand is gonna be the issue?
I think it's also the wrestling. As good as McDonald's, he showed a good sprawl in his last fight, but Tyron Woodley is a much better wrestler than Damian Maia, a tired Damian Maia. I think if the striking doesn't work well for Tyron Woodley, he can make it an ugly fight, initiate the clinch, or even utilize his wrestling to get the win here. I just have a feeling about Tyron Woodley here. to get to win. I usually pick Rory McDonald on my fights, but I think Tyron Woodley, you know, he especially when he beat Condon in his last fight, looked good too. And it's just been looking really good as of late, but Rory looked good in his last fight. Great fight here, but I gotta go with Woodley.
But you know, I disagree. I think the way McDonald, he's good on stand out, and I know Woody gonna go on the ground because the stand out wise, I think Royal got it. But don't forget, Royal McDonald has a good BJJ as well. I mean, if you give him a chance, he can use his BJJ and make the situation hostile. So I think, you know, if he got a situation, he able to utilize the situation, not just the BJJ, the good and Guan and Pong can come to us as a
good
use.
Scrambling.
He goes scrambling.
Yeah.
And then once he get out, good kickboxing right away, kick on the head, you don't know what's going to happen. So Roy McDonald all the way.
It can definitely happen. I forgot that Roy is a guy that's hard to keep on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So that can definitely work against Woodley. But yeah, I still got to go with Woodley. Like I said, if the striking doesn't go Woodley's way, I think that the wrestling can go Woodley's way.
Definitely.
I'll go with Woodley.
Okay.
Okay, next fight after that, we have Ryan Bader versus Rafael Feijão Cavalcante.
Ryan Bader, man. Today I just picked out all the big guy in there.
Yeah.
Ryan Bader, I mean, this guy's 16-4 records. 6 KO, TKO, 4 submission, 2 loss by KO, TKO. Two loss by submission. 31 years old, trained in the Power MMA. I mean, he has a great, strong wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
Good top control. I mean, you talk about have a good wrestling, the key, top control.
Yeah.
So he can kick the opponent on the ground. And
yeah.
Then what does he do? Good ground and pound. He will pound you to death.
And in his last fight, I mean, he was just ground and pounding Parash. He should have stopped the fight early, but... Yeah,
exactly. I mean, he is very deadly, and he has a good stand up and good overhead, you know, right overhead. I mean, this guy is very strong. Only thing I'm concerned is he's a weak defense.
Yeah, that's the thing with Bader. I mean, this guy is a guy that got dropped by Tito Ortiz, was actually winning against Glover Teixeira, and then got knocked out because his defense isn't that great. Went face first into a punch against Machida. But let's talk about Rafael Feijão Cavalcante.
Cavalcante, man, he's everything.
Yeah.
His 12-4 and 0-1 record, 11 KO, TKO. Oh my god, this guy can KO somebody. One submission, you know, and the 3 losses by KO, TKO, right? I mean, I love the guy. He has a good takedown defense. I mean, good counter, good wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, but you know, one thing, the reason I don't pick on him, it's just because he's so inconsistent.
Yeah, I know, man. He wants the Thiago Silva fight, and it's just kind of like, man, the guy just gassed in the first round. He was doing well, and then he got knocked out and pretty much gassed in the first round. Mike Kyle fight, you know, I mean, he ended up beating Mike Kyle, but then got a no contest.
I mean, he can be... I mean, I don't know. To me, he is really a tough fighter. He can be a lot of fighter with no problem. But it's not going to last for long. Like, a couple of rounds, he gets out, and you know, all the weakness is coming out.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing with Feijão. You know, he's 33 years old, training out of Team Nogueira and X-Gym. He's a finisher. This guy's a finisher. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt with good Muay Thai, really strong knees. He wants a King Mo fight. He wants his Yoel Romero fight for a lot of the stuff I'm going to talk about. Takedown defense, solid. Counter wrestling, disability, get back to his feet when he's taken down. Watch the King Mo fight, the Yoel Romero fight, and some other fights. He's good at getting back to his feet. His cardio isn't the greatest, though, and like I said, he's inconsistent. I'm actually going to go with Rafael Feijão Cavalcante here.
I understand, because I was going to pick on him as well. You know, the reason I don't want to pick on him, it's just because I think of the, you know,
Beta... Which one will show up, or what? No.
Beta top control wrestling, if he can get Cavalcante on the ground every now and then, I think he can tie him up. Okay. And then, you know, the way he fight, I mean, it's the wristy background, and I think he can tag him out and able to, you know, dominate the fight.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing is, it's going to be hard to take this guy down. Calvin Conte does have good takedown defense.
But he can try.
Yeah,
I think
he'll definitely
try.
Yes. His ability to get back to his feet when he's taken down is really good. And I think if he gets in close, he could be eating some knees. Mm. And this guy's pretty heavy-handed. So is Bader.
Bader's heavy-handed, too.
Yeah. They're both heavy-handed guys. I just think Feijão might be a little more diverse in the stand-up. And has enough counter-wrestling to counter Ryan Bader's wrestling. I'm going to go with Feijão. However, I will acknowledge his cardio doesn't always look great. And he has shown past performances where he hasn't looked great. I am kind of banking on the fact that he's going to look good in this fight.
No, I don't want to call it inconsistent. So I will go for Bader, and I want him focus tie, Rafael out, go for the wrestling. I mean, go for the longer, saving cardio, and then after that, when your opponent is tired, you can do anything you want.
Yeah. Okay, next fight after that, we have the fight between two guys with glass jaws, glass chins. So we have the returning Andre Arlovsky versus Brendan Schaub.
Brendan Schaub, I mean, he is such good, fighter to watch. 10-3 record, 7 KO, TKO, 1 submission, 3 loss by KO, TKO. Mm-hmm. 31 years old, 2-5 winning streak, okay? Mm-hmm. Where he train again?
Grudge.
I mean, look. He's a trained a good cat as well. Mm-hmm. I mean, good boxing, moving well, very, improved and impressive wrestling. He's been improving.
Mm-hmm.
Good BJJ, but like you said, they got a freaking glass chin. He's very weak. But you know what? I'm not worried because his opponent has a glass chin as well. So I'm thinking, utilize your boxing, moving well, with your head, try your wrestling, try the defender. Utilize your BJJ. I think he has a chance.
Well, you know what? Brendan Schaub, like you said, he moves well for his size.
Mm-hmm.
His wrestling has been improving. His Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, he actually choked out Matt Mitchell in his last fight.
See?
I'm going to say this right now. And I usually don't do this, but I think this fight's kind of 50-50. I'd actually favor Schaub just a little more.
Because
of youth. However, there's something of an emotional pick here, too.
What? Whoa. Talk about people.
Wow.
First, for a long time, you have an emotional pick.
I got an emotional pick.
You got a heart? Wow, huh? this is very interesting. Why? I need to hear this.
Okay, Andre Arlovsky. 21-10 record with 1-0 contest, 15 wins by KO or TKO.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy has more knockout wins than Brendan Schaub has fights. Three wins by sub. He does have 7 losses by KO or TKO.
Okay.
Yeah, he's 35 years old on a 2-fight win streak, training out of Jackson Winklejohn.
Mm-hmm.
And I think actually Schaub, I said grudge, I think he switches time between Grudge and somewhere in LA too.
Oh, cool.
Arlovsky is a former UFC heavyweight champion, and he's returning to the UFC. Last time he fought there was in March 2008. He has been fighting outside there, though.
Okay.
And is very active.
So he is active. So this is different. Sometimes when we say people who is not fighting for a long time, they actually don't do anything.
Yeah.
But this guy is active, so you can't really not count on the time he's not UFC.
Exactly. So he's a veteran. He's very experienced.
Uh-huh.
He's got some strong boxing. One of the things that is a good and bad about Arlovsky is that he stops being technical and he starts brawling, which might not be the worst thing against Schaub, because mm-hmm. if he connects against Schaub, but then it's kind of 50-50.
Yeah.
Arlovsky has shown some pretty good takedown defense, decent enough grappling, mm-hmm. You don't get to see too much of his ground game as of late. He does have a weak chin. But the other thing that's bad with him, Schaub kind of has this problem, but it's not as bad as Orlovsky, is that Orlovsky reacts really badly to when he gets hit clean. What I mean is he'll get hit. You see this against Karatanov. You saw this in the fourth Tim Sylvia fight.
Yeah.
He gets hit clean. Mm-hmm. He moves straight back with his chin high against the cage.
He's waiting for another shot.
And it's almost like he doesn't know what to do, almost. And then he usually gets blasted.
Oh, man.
Happens to him a lot. Could happen here.
Okay. Brandon Shaw, it is. Just tell me what you pick right now.
Right. I am going to go with Orlovsky, though. I don't know if he might be the better boxer.
Dude, you just told me your guy got hit and got to go straight by with chin out and waiting for another shot, and you still pick on him.
That's if Brandon Shaw hits him clean.
Dude, Brandon Shaw, he moved. He is pretty technical in some way. He is good boxing.
Yeah, it's solid.
You know, I think he can hit him clean.
I think Andre Arlovsky can hit him clean, though. That's the thing.
All right. We'll check it out. But they both have a weak chance, so 50-50. Whoever the other person with a happy hand that we could KO. Done.
Exactly. Get next fight after that. Ryan Jimmo fights Ovince St. Preux, OSP.
OSP, who do you got?
I'm going to go to OSP, but I'm very hesitant with this pick. OSP has a 15-5 record, mm-hmm. 7 wins by KO TKO, 4 wins by sub.
Mm-hmm.
He's 31 years old on a 4-fight win streak. Got some good stand-up, heavy hands.
Okay.
His grappling is improving. His cardio is questionable because sometimes he looks tired mm-hmm. or gassed, but I don't think he is.
Well, he's trying to use it as his advantage.
I get, like, there's fights that kind of go the distance where it's like his output lowers and he looks like it's a very weird thing, but he doesn't look so visibly gassed per se.
So he's somewhat gassed?
Yeah, he's just like somewhat gasses, I guess. You know, it's questionable, his cardio.
Okay. Well, you know, I don't know much about your guy. The reason I pick on my guy, because I like what I see. 19-3 records, 8 KO, TKO, 2 submission, 2 loss by KO, TKO, but it's also a lot of fight. That's what it is.
Mm-hmm.
32 years old. Trent, and where he trent?
The Black Zillions, man. Dude, with like Rashad Evans.
Yeah, see?
Matt Mitrione.
And the best thing is that this guy is big for 205.
Yeah.
You know, he's a big 205.
Evans is actually pretty big for 205 too. But you can tell, like, Jimmo's like meaty, you know?
Yeah, it is. It's solid. And I like his karate style stand up. I mean, it's very accurate. I mean, mm-hmm. another person who has a karate style is
obviously Machida, yeah, but exactly. He's not close to Machida.
Of course, who is close to Machida? But you know, well, I mean, in the UFC world, you have so many, you know, style you can choose. You want to go for karate? That means you want to go for accuracy,
mm-hmm.
Good clinch. I mean, definitely a boring fighter. But you know what? You know, I focus on accuracy. He clean. You know, get every opportunity you can how to dodge the fight. That's what it is.
Yeah, the reason why I'm a bit hesitant, I'm kind of picking like style over substance in a sense, because Ovince St. Preux is like interesting in the sense that he goes for things that most fighters don't go for. This guy goes for a body kick, follows up with a double leg takedown.
Okay.
He against Nikita Kralov, he went for the Von Fluchuk. I mean, he'll go for spinning stuff even. But Ryan Jimmo, you know, like I said, he's not exactly the most flashy fighter.
Mm-hmm.
He can clinch you up against a cage, kind of hold you there. And like I said, he has boring fights. That can happen a lot.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
and he ends up winning because of that.
Well, that's called being play conservative.
Yeah, he's very conservative.
Win,
yeah.
Right?
That's the thing. That's why I'm very hesitant to pick OSP.
Because the OSP style, I think he can be, you know, people who is a brawler, who is not able to, who doesn't have a game. I mean, Jimmo, he got it. He knows what's going on. You can't surprise him by doing that.
Mm-hmm.
He's so conservative, he will take the time to figure out. He knows how the game goes. So, I think he's a boring fighter. I don't like boring fighter, but look at Machida's style. I think, you know, they guarantee a win. I mean, not necessarily a takedown or a flashy choke slam, but a win's a win.
Yeah. One thing about Jimmo, though, that's really interesting is the time when he does actually let his hands go, he's like you said, he's very accurate.
Yes.
He actually has good, I say this all the time with Jimmo, he actually has a really good stand up, but he doesn't always show it. And against Sean O'Connell's last fight, he knocked him out. He knocked out Anthony Parash in 7 seconds in his first UFC fight. I mean, the guy can finish guys on the feet, and pretty emphatically, too. That's the thing. It's just he doesn't always choose to.
Because he doesn't want to, you know, risk it.
Yeah.
He's trying to, look, his record, 19-3 records, he tried to sustain his records.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's the thing with Jimmo. I'll go with OSP. He's a bit more flashy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, very, very kind of hesitant to pick him.
You know, I'm a accountant. I pick the people who don't take a risk and be conservative.
Okay, next. On to the prelims. We have Keiichi Kunimoto versus Daniel Sarafian.
Daniel, man. Daniel, all the way. I think you will agree with me on this one, right?
Yeah. The thing, you know, what's funny, Kunimoto in his last fight, he fought, Luis Dutra.
Mm-hmm.
And he showed, nothing in the fight. He got, he almost got finished, but he got hit in the back of the head. And he ended up winning by DQ. And I saw nothing in the fight about the guy.
I don't get him.
Well, the thing is, he has 8 submissions. So, you know... out of his 16 wins, you know he's good Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He's on a 5-fight win streak.
Well, he also have a 2 KO, but I don't see he used his hand that much.
Nah. And Darren El Serafian's freaking huge, man.
Right?
I think this is going to be at 170.
I understand he doesn't have the best record in there.
8-4.
I mean, 50-50, right?
Yeah.
But the guy's, like you said, huge. The guy has a good kickboxing.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, he's good.
Out of his 8 wins, 7 of them are by submission.
And then 1 is a decision, you know.
Yeah.
But not just because it is what it is. Everybody got decision every now and then,
yeah.
Right?
The thing is, he's 31 years old. He actually has good stand-up, which is kind of funny. And the Ultimate Fighter Brazil, I think he won it one of his, one of his fights, excuse me,
mm-hmm.
by a flying knee. I mean, the guy can knock guys out. He has heavy hands.
Like I say, he has heavy hands. He can use his knee, you know, necessary, maybe leg. But the most important thing, he has really strong BJJ.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, he's a submissioner.
Yeah. Even on the bottom against, I remember a CB Dalloway fight.
Mm-hmm.
Guy did an awesome half guard sweep to single leg takedown. It was a beautiful thing of beauty. You know, he has tricks like that from the bottom.
I think he's big for 170.
I mean, he was already pretty huge for 185. He just wasn't tall, but he is really wide. I think it's his first cut to 170, which could affect him. But otherwise, I think he's in the right weight class.
I think by cutting the first to the 170, it definitely affect most of the people.
Mm-hmm.
But I just hadn't really seen much
Kunimoto
to be worried about. I'm not saying he is not good. I just say I haven't seen much about this. So, you know my pick.
Oh, Daniel Sarafian for the win, though.
Of course.
Okay, next fight. After that, we have a women's fight as Valerie Letourneau fights Elizabeth Phillips. Both females are taking the fight on short notice. Phillips more so than Letourneau.
Which girl would you like?
You know, I'll go with Valerie Letourneau. 5-3 record.
Uh-huh.
4 wins by KO or TKO. 1 win by sub.
Man.
She's 31 years old, training out at TriStar,
mm-hmm.
along the likes of Roy McDonald. It's her first fight in the UFC. She is taking the fight on short notice, but she is a good I saw one of her fights. Good kickboxer, I liked her kicks. Her output isn't the greatest, though, which
mm-hmm.
I'm not very fond of. Her grappling was kind of because she did get out-grappled by Roxanne Modafferi on Ultimate Fighter.
Mm-hmm.
However, one thing that's kind of good about her is, even though she has a 5-3 record, her 3 losses are to some of the top fighters in the world, and Claudia Gadelha,
mm-hmm.
Alexis Davis, and Sarah Kaufman. So that's not a bad look for her.
No, it's not at all.
Yeah.
Well, you know, but not just that. I like how he How's she fight? She's really aggressive.
Are you talking about Phillips or?
I talk about Phillips.
Oh, okay, okay.
Ryan Phillips is she's aggressive, right?
Yeah, I remember seeing her fight against like Michelle Deer. I mean, that was just push forward and aggressiveness.
Yeah, I think, you know, that's why I like a Phillips. I mean, I know that, you know, you have your pick, but you got to understand, Phillips is aggressive. She pushed forward. She got 4-1 record. I mean, 2 KO, TKO, 1 submission, 4 fight winning streak. You know, first fight in USC, but he take...
So is valedictorian.
You know,
so.
I mean, the both are first fight in USC, but she is aggressive. I mean, that's something that... You know, I don't know most of the fighters takes out when they first fight UFC, you know?
One thing about that's interesting about Phillips is she does train at Sikjutsu. Other notables that trained that would be Sam Cecilia, Michael Chiesa, and of course, Ultimate Fighter winner Juliana Pena.
Yes.
So she definitely has a good training partner there in Pena.
Exactly.
So that's pretty promising. Otherwise, I'll go with Latornia to win. Yeah, Phillips, right?
Phillips.
Okay, cool. Next fight after that, at 135 pounds, we have Mike Easton versus Eve Jabouin.
You know, let's do any respect to the Mike Easton. I mean, 13-4 records, 4 KO, TKO, 2 submissions, 30 years, so he is in 3-5 losing streak. Okay?
Yeah.
Eat your brain, man,
yeah.
My man, dude. You know, I mean, homie, dude, call me. 19-9 records, 11 KO, TKO, 1 submission, 4 loss by KO, TKO. Like I said, everybody do that every now and then. 3 loss by submission, 35 years old, 1 year older than me, training in the where?
TriStar, along with Latorno and McDonald, yep.
What does he got? Why am I going to love my boy? You know, he got good kickboxing. Awesome kicks.
Yeah, he goes for spinning kicks as well.
Yeah, right? I mean,
yeah.
I can't do that, so, you know.
Yeah.
Improving on the grappling and the wicking chin, but his kickboxing is fun to watch.
It is, but he's fighting Mike Easton, 13-4 record. Well, you already said all that stuff, but he trains out of Alliance with the likes of, like, Dominic Cruz,
mm-hmm.
Michael Chandler, and Ross Pearson and whatnot. Eve Jabouin, of course, trains at TriStar.
Yeah.
So, good camps here.
I mean, like Eve Jabouin, come on.
Well, the thing with Easton is he's really strong. His stand-up is good. His counter-punching is actually pretty good. His takedown defense is solid. His losses in the 3-fight losing streak are to now champion TJ Dillashaw.
Okay.
Brad Pickett, who's like really good. And, geez, if I can only remember the other one. But it's all, like, the in this 3-fight losing streak, it's all two very good. Oh, I think it's a Sun Chao.
Oh,
and
wow.
They're all top guys. I mean, it's all, like, the top guys. So,
how soon going to be Eve Jabouin?
Well, the thing is, Eve Jabouin's not a top guy. So, I'm going to go with Easton. I think he can get his counterpunching game going in. As long as he doesn't wait on Jabouin, which he might do, I think Mike Easton can win.
Look, Jabouin is a guy, he knows he's good at kickboxing. I mean, he's really good with his kicks. I mean, as
mm-hmm.
long as Jabouin's focus lower level focus on core, focus on kick,
mm-hmm.
I mean, keep the distance. You know, every now and then he draws on jab, fake some kicks. I think Jabouin can play steady. He has a chance to win this fight.
No,
okay?
He does.
You know, but obviously, if he land inside, you know, land the Easter coming in, obviously with Jabouin's chin, I mean, I don't know what's gonna happen. I mean, but if he keep a distance, play
mm-hmm.
smart, I think. There is a chance for him to win.
Cool. Okay, next we have that. Kajon Johnson fights one of your countrymen, Taehyun Bang.
Taehyun Bang, man, just because he's Korean. 16-8 records, you know, I mean, I don't know. He's Korean. He eats kimchi. He has to win.
I mean, he has 8 wins by KO, TKO, and 8 wins by decision. I mean, that kind of says right there that
he's
guy wants to... To bang.
To bang.
He wants to bang.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing.
I mean, you know, he 31 years old, trained in the Korean top team.
Yeah, other guys that train out of Korean top team, another good fighter there would be Hung Yu Lim, actually. Hung Yu Lim.
I mean, overall, I think he's
stand-up.
He's a pretty good stand-up. Mm-hmm. He has heavy-handed. I definitely think he has a KO power.
Cool. Well, Kajun Johnson, 19-10 record with one draw, 4 wins by KO TKO, 11 wins by sub. He also has 3 losses by KO TKO, so that's a bit worrisome against a guy like Bang.
Bang.
And 3 losses by sub on a 2-fight losing streak. I remember he fought in the Ultimate Fighter. He did really well. He trains at Tricer. I really like his Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu skills. I remember seeing him in MFC. He always had really good back control. And his overall ground game's good, but I was always impressed by his back control. His stand-up's solid. It's not great, but it is solid. I think his strength really is in the grappling. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go Kajun Johnson to win this one, to win with superior grappling.
So you're not worried by they both meet on the stand-out and the tapang going to bang his ass?
You know, it's definitely a possibility, considering Kajun, he also got knocked out pretty bad against Chad Laprise on The Ultimate Fighter. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like I said, he's a good fighter. I think if he can get the fight to the ground, he'll be good to go. I'm kind of banking on that. That's where I'm going with Kajun Johnson.
All right, Tapang, just bang. Just make sure no ground game. Let's not go on the ground. You know, kick his ass, you know, give him some bang power, you know, then we can all go home, eat some Korean barbecue, right?
Hey, man, you know, there's good food in Canada, right? Right? I mean, that's where Tricer is, so that's where Kajun's from. Fish?
Okay, nothing can be kimchi.
Okay, onto the Fight Pass prelims. We have Roland Delorme versus Michinoru Tanaka.
Tanaka, I mean, gotta go for Tanaka. Why? 9-0 undefeated records, bro. 5 submission, 4 decision, 23 years old, good BJJ. First time in UFC, nobody know who he is, what he does, but you know why? He's good clinch. He's really small for 135, but you know why? The guy's good, mm-hmm. good speed, you know, undefeated.
Yeah, one thing about Tanaka that's really interesting is that I believe it was Patrick Wyman and Bloody Elbow. He had a searching for future champions. He was actually, it's a top 25 list of like the top prospects
mm-hmm.
not signed yet to the UFC or Bellator.
Here
he is. He was number 24. And that says a lot. That's a really good list. A lot of the guys on that list have made it to the UFC and have done well.
Mm-hmm.
Or they signed, they're with World Series of Fighting, and they've done pretty well. He is fighting a pretty tough guy in Roland Delorme, though. 9-2 record with 1 no contest, 2 wins by KO TKO, 6 wins by sub. He's 30 years old. He's also got good Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu himself and a good scrambler. You see that in a lot of his fights, actually. Edwin Figueroa, Alex Caceres, really good there. Stand-up's decent. He has decent enough wrestling. He can get fights to the ground. And he's a tough... He's just this guy that totally falls under the radar,
mm-hmm.
but is actually pretty solid. He came from the Ultimate Fighter. He didn't win it or anything, but he actually turned out to be a solid fighter, you know? I gotta go with Roland Delorme. I think this might be a pretty tough matchup for Tanaka. I think Delorme can definitely match him on the ground. I think he can scramble back to his feet if he's taken down. I heard that, especially with his size, I heard Tanaka has a hard time keeping guys on the ground, especially since he's small for the weight class.
Yeah, but that also means he's very hard to keep on the ground as well. Don't forget Tanaka, he has some speed going on,
mm-hmm.
you know, not just focus on the ground, his clinch is really good.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, clinch doesn't necessarily have to be the, you know, the size, it had just be the power and the technique.
Mm-hmm.
I think he got, I mean, again, his top prospect, I think he has what he got, that's why everybody put him on number 24.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, man, it'd be interesting now. I'm curious to see what Tanaka looks like against Delorme. And if he's going to maybe cut down to 125 after this fight.
Yeah, I mean, again, he's the first fight UFC. A lot of times the first fight UFC, they, you know, I'm hoping the fight was somewhat picked for him to get him the opportunity to win, not just, you know, destroy his UFC career. So let's see how it goes.
Okay, and finally, this one's kind of a pick-em fight for me. It's Jason Sago fights Josh Shockley.
Well, you know, I mean, like you say, the boxing record is pretty decent. I mean, Jason has a 9-1 record, one TKO, a submission. This guy can submit people, obviously. 28 years old, 5 winning streak.
Four fight
winning streak. It's definitely a finisher. You know, first time UFC as well, good clinch, good grappling. I mean, when I look at the Josh, you know, Shockley, I mean, they just so identical.
They're pretty much the same guy. Josh Shockley, 11-2 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 5 wins by sub. That's just 2 losses by submission. It's on a 2-fight win streak, trained out of Dunlin, Valley Tudo, along the likes of like Darren Elkins, Eddie Weiland, Keith Wisniewski. It's his first fight in the UFC. Decent stand-up. Same with Sago, actually.
Yeah, they both have decent stand-up.
You know, and he's also a good grappler. I have seen Shockley fight in Bellator. Sago, though, does have some good wins. He most recently beat EJ Brooks. And I think, if I'm not mistaken,
the fight could go either way. They both have a similar style. They both have a same fair advantage to one or the other. I definitely, you know, don't see there's a big difference. I pick Jason just because, you know, I feel submission-wise he might be a little bit better.
Yeah, I'll go with Shockley. Like I said, I've seen him in Bellator. He's actually pretty good. Fought some good competition there. And overall, his competition's not too bad considering there's a regional scene. I'll go Josh Shockley.
All right, go for Jason.
Okay. Let's go recap, man.
All right.
Yeah, we got Demetrius Johnson versus Ali Bagayitunov.
My big boy Johnson, dude.
Okay. Demetrius Johnson. Okay. Rory McDonald fights Tyron Woodley.
Rory McDonald, man.
Okay. I got Tyron Woodley.
Traitor.
Ryan Bader fights Rafael Cavalcante.
Another big guy, Ryan Bader.
Okay. I got Rafael Cavalcante. Andre Arlovsky fights Brendan Schaub.
Brendan Schaub.
Okay. I got Andre Arlovsky. And Ryan Jimmo versus Ovince St. Preux.
Jimmo!
Okay, I got Ovince St. Preux. On to the prelims, which are going to be on FX.
FX.
So it's Keiichi Kunimoto versus Daniel Serafian.
What do you got?
Daniel Serafian.
That's what I got.
Okay, Valerie Letourneau fights Elizabeth Phillips.
Elizabeth Phillips.
Okay, I got Valerie Letourneau. Mike Easton fights Eve Jabouin.
Eve Jabouin.
Okay, I got Mike Easton.
I know you want Eve Jabouin.
Cajun Johnson fights Taihoon Bang.
Taihoon Bang. Big Bang.
Yeah, I got Cajun Johnson. On the fight pass prelims, Roland Delorme fights Michinori Tanaka.
Tanaka.
Okay, I got Roland Delorme. And Jason Sago fights Josh Shockley.
Jason Sago.
Okay, I got Josh Shockley. So that's it for our predictions for UFC 174, Johnson versus Bagayitunov. If you have any comments, just leave them below. You got any final words, my man?
Don't have final war, have a lot of war.
Yeah.
Well, this is great fight. I think it's very interesting. It's definitely something we can take a look at. But if you guys have any, you know, dream card, any question, you know, anything you want us to analyze, you know, super fight, just leave it in the comment and we will address that. You know, what's the UFC gonna happen? I mean, anything. Just subscribe us, give us a question, and we can do a special episode just for that.
Nice, man. Nice. Yeah, we haven't done a special episode in a long time.
Exactly.
Yeah, so, well, let's get that going on one of these days. And yeah, that's pretty much it for MMA for You. Thank you guys very much.